Obviously, it was a disappointing result against Oxford, and I know that the manager afterwards said, well, he was angry, and he said, you know, players have got to sink or swim now. Has that message got through to the squad, and are you sort of keen to put that result right now against Birmingham?
Yeah, definitely. We always look to the next game straight after a loss or a bad performance. Not saying that was a bad performance, but anything like that, you always look to the next game to like correct it. So I didn't actually get to see that game. I didn't travel, but you were on about the cup game, right?
Yes.
Yeah. No, I didn't travel. I didn't get to see that game, but I was watching out for it on Sky, and I see we went 2-0 up, so I thought, oh, it's a good result. But then I don't really know what happened after that. After speaking to some of the lads, both teams made a couple of changes, and it game just kind of died down a little bit after that. So, like I say, it is what it is when we go to the next one, and we try to put all the games behind us and always look to the next game.
I assume you had the day off yesterday, although you probably met up this morning. You had a training session. I was just wondering if you'd seen a reaction from the players after that disappointment.
Yeah, well, second day after a game, the lads that did play are normally inside, but each training session, win, lose or draw, we're all as a team putting it in on the training pitch. So everyone was out there today. The lads that played came in a little bit earlier, but the lads that stayed out there was putting a good session in this nice weather outside today.
Yeah, absolutely. It has been a tough time. I know it's very, very early on in the season, but you as one of the more experienced players, do you see it as one of your responsibilities to lift characters in the dressing room?
Yeah, I mean, it is a young team. There is a couple of, well, two or three older heads in there. But even the young lads have got, some of them have got an old head on their shoulders. But yeah, me, the captain, Grimesy, Jay, Joe, Allen now, we put our arms around players and stuff. But like I said, it's still early days. It is only three games in. So I don't think anyone's panicking, as to say yet. In the first game, I thought we played well. We created a lot of chances, just about changing them into goals. And then Blackburn, I thought we played good in parts of the game. It's just the ending again, finishing for us. And then they had four shots, probably ended up scoring three goals, which is it's not good enough for us as a defence. We need to cut that out. But I wouldn't say we're panicking or anything like that.
Have you got to tighten up as a defence? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I mean, in some games, like I said, they only actually had four shots, I think it was. So sometimes you can have three shots and three goals going. Sometimes you can have 20 shots and not none going. Do you know what I mean? So it was just one of them games where it seemed that every time they had a shot, it went in. But yeah, in some senses, we do have to tighten up a little bit. But like I said, it's early days. We're working on it still. We had a good pre-season and stuff. So like I said, we're still taking every game as it comes.
The manager said after the Blackburn game that the way that that you play, the style of football that you play, invites a lot of criticism from other teams. Do you as players defend your style? Do you feel that it is a potentially winning style of football and that it will bring results?
Definitely. Since the gaffer's come in, I've probably enjoyed myself playing this style of football more than I ever have. I love it. The amount of ball that we have and stuff is growing up is you want to be a footballer, and this is for me being a footballer. I'm fully with it, and yeah, I mean, I'm sure everybody is. Everybody, and that's why you get a lot of people wanting to sign here to play this type of football. You speak to some lads after games and they're like, Jesus, you're a good team, aren't you? And that's what you want. But like I said, we need to change a couple of performances and just finish your teams off.
Because he adopts you as in the middle of a three where you're really dictating the play at the back. Is that something that you found almost your, I'd say, dream position, but your preferred position now?
Yeah, I mean, I'm happy to play anywhere. I'll play anywhere on the pitch, but last season I can't lie, I did enjoy it. And I had a lot of ball And a lot of the build up normally starts with me, and that's ideal for me. But like I say, if I have to move positions or we change formation for whatever reason, I'm more than happy to go, and I'd just leave it all out there. And so yeah.
What would you say to some fans who feel that maybe the style is too slow or too laboured? Have they got to be patient? Have people got to be patient watching Swansea City and the way that you play?
Yeah, no, I mean, I don't always think it's slow. Sometimes the build-up can be a little bit slow, but we are waiting for a trigger and waiting for the right time, you know, to play a killer pass or anything. We don't want to just be like a lot of the other teams, getting it in defence and, you know, kicking it straight over the other. We are a team that is patient in possession and wait for the right time. But yeah, I mean, that's just how we play. I enjoy it. I speak to a lot of people that I've watched and also enjoy watching us. So, but like I said, I don't really read too much into social media or you know, so I don't really know what gets said on that front.
Could you see yourself finishing your career at this club? I know you've still got a fair few years in front of you, but you've been here so long, you're part of the furniture now. Would you be happy to finish your career at Swansea City?
Yeah, I would. Like, since I've been here, I've had 3 kids. They all love it. My missus loves it. My parents, when they come, my missus' parents, we all love it. I'd be more than happy to finish my career at Swansea, but it's one thing saying it and it's another thing happening. So as you get a bit older, I like to take it year by year. That's one of the reasons I'm on another year contract. But yeah, I'm thoroughly enjoying it at this club.
Yeah, so much has changed since you first arrived all those years ago. Of course, the club was in the Premier League at that time. What would it mean for you personally, for the club, to eventually get back to the top flight?
I mean, not only for me, for everyone. I mean, but for me personally, it would be a big achievement as well, because I feel like the players and the staff and everyone, they deserve, you know, and fans, to go back to the Premier League. And if that can happen while I'll be here, I'll be a happy man when I do leave, if I've left it where I found it.
In this weather, Blackpool away is a bit of it's an appealing away day, shall we say, for a lot of fans. So I'm sure there'll be a big travelling support. And you can make it an even better weekend, I guess, by getting the first 3 points of the season. That would be important, wouldn't it?
Yeah, I mean, that's the hope. No matter who we play or where we go, we always want to get 3 points. But yeah, hopefully this weekend we can start well, get out of the blocks fast and get the 3 points this weekend. That'd be nice.
Thanks very much, Kyle.
Thank you. And Carl, you touched on it there with the formations and different playing styles. We saw a lot of it, particularly in the summer, where we saw you at times playing further forward in the middle of a back three in different slots. How do you think that will help the team overall over the course of a 46-game season, being able to adapt?
Well, it just gives us something else to change with. We can look at the opposition if we think we need to change formation or whatever, and that's just good. And that's the good part of having a pre-season. We can, you know, try things, and even during a game, if the game's not going in our way or however we want it, we can change it during the game because we've trained a lot on it and stuff. So yeah, I feel like it's always good to, you know, try new things.
We haven't spoken to you since you signed that new 1-year deal. I suppose from what you've just said there, Russell Martin, his coaching staff and the style, that was all part of the reason for you wanting to stay here another year.
Oh yeah, definitely. I spoke to the manager before I signed, well, a while before I signed, and he was saying how much he wanted to keep me, but to be honest, he didn't really have to say that because I enjoyed the year that much of playing that style of football. I wanted to stay and I wanted to sign. So it was a bit of a no-brainer for me.
And in terms of the back three, Harry Darling and Nathan Wood both spoke very highly of you after the Rotherham game. What would you say about them two, and how have you found the early month or so that you've been playing with them?
Yeah, they've been class. They're good guys. First and foremost, it always helps. But they're good players. Harry's obviously played this style of football before at MK, and young Wood is also learning this style of football, but I feel like he's a quick learner and he's getting it quick, which always helps. So hopefully he can kick on, and Harry's kind of slotted in, so that's good as well.
And we've seen quite a number of departures this summer as well. I think two more confirmed today, Jordan Garrick and Carl Joseph on loan. But do you still think the squad as a whole might be a little bit light to cope with that Saturday, Tuesday, Saturday? And there's still 3 weeks to go in the window. Is there still work to be done in incomings, do you think?
Do I think? I have no idea. I don't know. As far as the young lads who have gone going out, I feel like if you're not playing at a club, that's the best thing for them, to go out and play as many games as they can. And that's good for them. And it's also good for the club, because obviously if they perform, they get a chance to come back and, you know, try and help this team kick on. But yeah, as far as if there's anyone coming in, or I have no idea, but whether there is or isn't, the amount of players who are here and the quality is here, we've got a good chance of, you know, hopefully achieving something this season.